In this lecture, I want to talk about vibrations of one-dimensional monoatomic lattice. We know that in our laboratory, we have lattice dynamic kit, and by using that kit, we can perform these three experiments. That is, first one is the study of the dispersion relation for the monoatomic lattice. Second one is determination of the cutoff frequency of the monoatomic lattice. And the third one is the study of the dispersion relation for the diatomic lattice. And we can also see various modes in diatomic lattice, which are acoustic mode and optical mode. So first, let me explain the theory of this dispersion relation for the monoatomic lattice. For this, let first assume some atoms in the lattice. Let's say I am assuming these 6 atoms. And these atoms are connected by these massless springs. And here there is no stress or extension in these springs. So we can say this as equilibrium state. But due to lattice vibrations, these atoms can be displaced from their equilibrium position. Let's say this atom or this atom is displaced to this position, and this atom is displaced to this position, and this atom is displaced to this position. Similarly, these 3 atoms are displaced here, here and here. Now let's, this is nth atom, then this is n plus 1th atom, and this is n minus 1th atom. Let's say this atom is displaced with this coordinate un, and this atom is displaced with un plus 1, and a similar fashion this atom is displaced with un minus 1. And of course there are springs that are connecting these atoms. So let me write some points here. So suppose each atom Suppose each atom has mass, equal mass, which is equal to m, and is attached to other atoms by massless springs. If U is the displacement of a spring, with spring constant beta, then the force exerted by a spring on an atom can be written as F, which is equal to beta U. And here we have to consider only this atom, and we can see there is a force on this atom, which is nth atom, due to this n plus 1th atom, and there is also a force on this atom by this atom, which is n minus 1th. So we have to consider both of these forces, and we know that by Hooke's law, F equal to minus kx or kx. But here, since we have to use another symbol k for wave vector, so instead of, normally we use this k as symbol for spring constant, but here we are using beta as spring constant, because we have to use another k as wave vector. So to differentiate between these symbols, here we are using, or in most of the books there is beta as spring constant. We can write this beta as k1 and this wave vector k2, but for simplicity here we are using beta as spring constant. So now we have to know this displacement u or extension in the spring. So we can write this force F, which is equal to beta. So first we have to consider the force due to this n plus 1th atom, and we can write here extension as un plus 1 minus un. And similarly, we can consider force by this atom by using extension, which is equal to un minus 1 minus un. So we can write this force as beta, which is equal to un plus 1 minus un plus beta, that is force due to atom at n minus 1th position, which is equal to un minus 1 minus un. But here we can see that un minus 1 is smaller than un, so we can write it as un plus 1 minus un minus beta un minus un minus 1. So here we can see that there are 2 un with minus sign. So we can write this equation as f, which is equal to beta un plus 1 plus this un minus 1 minus these 2, which is 2 un. So this is our first equation. So this is our equation number first. So this is the force exerted by the spring on the atom at position n. So by using this force, we can get the equation of motion, and we know that F is equal to m into acceleration. So in a similar way, the equation of motion of the atom can be written as m d square u by dt square, which is equal to F, and F is equal to, we know that, beta un plus 1 plus un minus 1 minus 2 un. This is equation number second. And we know that in a lattice or crystal, atoms are arranged in periodic manner. So we have to consider that periodicity in the solution of this equation. So a periodic solution to this equation or this is a wave equation. So we can write periodic solution of this wave equation can be written as un, which is equal to u naught into, we have to include this exponential iota omega t minus k n a. Let's say this is equation number third. And here NA is the x coordinate. Of the nth atom, and we can understand this NA very easily if we see this diagram. This is the nth atom. Let's say here we have our center, then we are counting from here to this atom as N, and if A is the lattice constant, then the distance between this center and this nth atom is equal to Na, x equal to Na. So I am just putting this value in equation number third. So I am writing directly the solution of this equation third. So on solving, equation 3, we get omega, which is equal to plus minus 4 beta by m into sine of ka by 2. Let's say this is equation number 4th. And this solution of omega can be understand or remember very easily if you know about coupled oscillation. We know that for a mass m with spring constant k, we can write omega, which is equal to k by m, under root k by m. But if there are two atoms or bodies with same mass m that are connected by this spring with spring constant k, then the coupled oscillation of this system can be written as omega, that is frequency of this first atom, which is equal to under root k by m, plus the frequency of this atom, which is again k by under root k by m. So we can add these two terms and we can write it 2 k by m, and we can take this 2 in the root by using 4 k by m under root. But here atoms are periodic in nature in a crystal, so we have to introduce this sine function also. So we can remember this solution very easily if we know what is coupled oscillation. Now we know that lattice vibrations can produce phonons, that is sound wave, or photons, that is electromagnetic waves. So now our first aim is to replace this beta by m. So if C is the stiffness constant, or longitudinal constant, and P is the mass per unit length, that is equal to M by A, then sound velocity or velocity of sound, sound velocity can be written as Vs, which is equal to under root C by P, where Vs is the sound velocity. And if you know what is stiffness constant, that is C, just acting like force. So we can write C as beta A. So, and we also know what is P, which is equal to M by A. So we can write C by P as beta A by M A. And we can also write it as beta A square by M. But in our equation, we have to replace this beta by m. So from here we can write beta by m, which is equal to 1 by a square c by p. So by putting this value of beta by m in the equation number, it's fourth, in equation fourth, then we can write equation fourth, which is omega. So on putting of value of beta by m in equation 4, we get omega, which is equal to plus minus, let me first write, it's 1 by a square, we have to replace this b by m, which is equal to 1 by a square c by p, and 4 is already in that equation. So equation 4 will become as omega equal to plus minus 4 by a square c by p under root into sine k by a, and we can take 4 by a square from outside this under root sign. So we can write omega, which is equal to plus minus 2 by a under root c by p sine k a by 2. And we also note that what is under root c by p. So omega, which is equal to plus minus 2 by a vs sine k a by 2. So this is the solution of equation number second. And one important thing is that since the frequency omega should be always positive, irrespective of the sine of k, we take always the magnitude of omega, that is omega, we can take only positive value, that is 4 beta by m under root sine k a by 2, and by putting the value of this beta by m, we can write omega, which is equal to 2 vs by a into sine k a by 2. So this is our equation number fifth. So here we can see that this omega can vary with k. So equation fifth is called as dispersion relation. And that can be plotted as so now let me change color of this my pen. This is the boundary of the first Brillouin zone. On this scale it is K, and on this scale it is omega. So these are the boundaries of first Brillouin zone. So this is the dispersion relation for omega. Let's say this is point B and A. So now we have to consider various frequency to know the cutoff frequency of this atomic system. So first, and here it's zero. So first, let's consider low frequency. So at low frequency, K tends to zero, and we know that at lower value of theta, sine theta is always equal to theta. So here we can write sine ka by 2, which tends to equal to ka by 2. So by putting this ka by 2 in equation number 5, so equation number or equation 5 gives us omega 2 by A Vs into Ka by 2. We can cancel these two and these A. So we can write omega is equal to Vs Vsk. So let's, this is equation number 6. Now we have to consider phase velocity and group velocity. And I think you remember that, or we know that phase velocity Vp is given as omega by k. And so from equation 6, we get Vp, which is equal to Vsk by k, which is equal to Vs. So the phase velocity for this system is equal to this sound velocity. Let's say this is equation number 7. And we also know that the group velocity that is Vg is given as Vg which is equal to d omega by dk. And from equation 6 we can get Vg which is equal to d omega by dk, and what is omega? Omega is Vsk, so we can write it as Vs. So from here Vg is also equal to Vs. Let's say this is question number 8. So we can say that at low frequency Vp, that is phase velocity, is equal to group velocity, and which is equal to sound velocity. So this is the case when we use very low frequency. Let's say it's equation number 9. Now we can consider a case with higher frequency. So at higher frequency we know that phase velocity is equal to omega by k. So from here we can say that 2 Vs by a sine ka by 2 by k. So we can write phase velocity as 2 Vs Ka into sine Ka by 2. Let's say this is equation number 10. And we can write group velocity Vg, which is equal to d omega by dk. So d, and what is omega, which is 2 Vs by a into sine Ka by 2. So we can differentiate this equation with respect to k, and we can get Vg which is equal to Vs 2 Vs by a into cos of Ka by 2 into A by 2. So we can cancel these twos and also A. So we can get Vg which is equal to Vs cos Ka by 2. So this is the value of group velocity. Or simply we can write Vg, which is equal to Vs cos of Ka by 2. Let's say this is equation number 11. What is equation number 11? Here we can see, here both Vg and Vp, that is group velocity and phase velocity, are functions of frequency. This is referred to as the phenomenon of dispersion. And the medium is called as dispersive medium. But we can see that at longer wavelength, or smaller frequencies, Vg equal to Vp, Vg is equal to Vs. And there is no relation to frequency with Vp and Vg, that is dispersion effect is negligible and the medium behaves as a homogeneous continuous medium, and for lower frequency we can draw a graph like this. So this is for lower frequency where there is no dispersion effect. Now let's take third case, that is at frequency where omega is equal to 4 beta by m. that is Ka by 2 equal to pi by 2. So therefore omega equal to 4 beta by m means we are taking 4 beta by m sine Ka by 2. Here we are considering this as 1, sine Ka by 2 as 1, and sine is 1 at pi by 2. So here we are considering Ka by 2 equal to pi by 2. So we can write it as Ka by 2, which is equal to pi by 2. We can cancel this. This implies that and we know that what is K? K is nothing but 2 pi by lambda. So 2 pi by lambda A, which is equal to pi. We can cancel this pi by pi. So we can write here lambda is equal to 2A. And from here we can get Vp equal to two Vs by pi and Vg is equal to 0. If we consider this, that is omega equal to, by putting this value of Vs or another thing, here omega equal to 4 beta by m. Since there is no term that can depend on k, so d omega by dk equal to 0. So here we can only get phase velocity, which is equal to Vp, sorry, this is Vp, phase velocity, which is equal to 2 Vs by pi, and here group velocity, which is equal to d omega by dk, which is Vg. So here Vg is equal to 0. So there is no group velocity and only phase velocity is there at when we use omega equal to 4 beta by under root 4 beta by n. So since Vg equal to 0, there is no transfer of signal and the wave behaves like a standing wave. A standing wave doesn't have a group velocity and it can only have a phase velocity. So from here we can see that only the vibrations which are between 4 beta by m or only the vibrations with frequency lower than this under 4 beta by m can propagate through the lattice. Since at omega, when we put omega equal to under root 4 beta by m, there is no group velocity. This means there is no transfer of mass. So we can't use this frequency, because this frequency can't propagate in the lattice. So we have to use this frequency as the upper limit. So here we can see that, so here the lattice behaves like a filter and the frequency between 0 and under root 4 beta by m can propagate through the lattice. So this is our cutoff frequency for a monoatomic lattice. So, and we can also see here, if we see the graph of this dispersion relation, which is this, so we know that group velocity is d omega by dk, and if we see this curve at zone boundary has slope 0, it means we know that Vz group velocity is equal to d omega by dk, and d omega by dk is the slope of this curve. So here slope is 0, it means Vz by 0 at pi by a and minus pi by a. So this is all about vibrations in one dimensional monoatomic lattice. Here first we consider atoms with equal mass of m that are connected by massless springs, and first we have written their equation of force. Then by that force we have written equation of motion, and by using a periodic solution of displacement, then we get the actual solution in terms of omega, which is equal to under root 4 beta by m into sine k a by 2, and here sine function is written, or sine function comes due to the periodicity of the atoms in a lattice. And here we also see that a monoatomic lattice can allow this frequency to propagate, which is in between 0 and 4 beta by m, under root 4 beta by m. So if the mass of the atom is larger, then this frequency is lower, and if the mass of the atom is lower, then this cutoff frequency is higher. So this is the cutoff frequency. So in next lecture we will see the vibrations of one dimensional diatomic lattice, and after that we will do the actual experiment in our laboratory.